the richest, the wisest. Amen. Please let's be on our feet for the word of presentation. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 to 16. Ephesians chapter 5, 2 verses 15 and 16. Amen. We take it at the count of two. One, two, go. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time because the days are evil. Let's take it one more time. Ephesians chapter 5. Verses 15 and 16. Want to go? Look therefore carefully how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, redeeming the time because the days are evil. Thank you, Father, for your words. Bless us this week and many, many days, weeks, and months and years to come in Jesus' name. Visited in God's presence. This is wisdom for living. He says, let's watch. Let's look carefully. Let's watch and move and do our things as wise children, because our God is a wise God. Amen. And that's why he says, is there anyone that lacks wisdom, such a one should ask of God, that give it to all men liberally. God is a God of wisdom. And this God will help us in our marriages, in our career. God will help us to walk in wisdom in Jesus' name. There are some things that we've already known, but I want to emphasize more on it. Certain times we embark on STP without agreeing with our spouse is unwise. It is not good. Some years ago, I met a lady and I said to her, do you like this dress? She said, wow, it's lovely. I like it. But mama, I can't buy a dress. I can't engage in buying anywhere without talking to my husband first. I have to agree with him. I looked at her. I said, well, this is a wise lady. This is a wise wife. Amen. That means she has her husband in high esteem. Things are costly in Nigeria. Our economic situation is not what it's supposed to be. You can't compare it with other countries and continents of the world. But a wise woman knows how to handle things. Buy only the needful. Hallelujah. Don't go about looking for what you want, what you desire. Don't overstretch yourself financially. The other time, I saw a video that has gone viral, and it's about a man. He said to the people that were listening to him, that if you have paid school fees, and you don't have money for a scholarship. How many of us saw the video? Okay, only daddy. If you have paid school fees and you don't have money for a scholarship, and it's taking away your sleep, it says, don't go and sleep. Don't allow it to take away your sleep. When it's time for a scholarship and other children have gone, you don't have the money, gather them together. Gather your children together and teach them the word of God. Praise the Lord. Let nothing trouble you financially. Do only the things you're supposed to do. Don't go, you borrow from this, you take a loan here, you borrow from this person, you borrow from this person. No. Cut your coat according to your size, and I say height. Praise the Lord. One woman talked to me the other time, and I looked at her, I said, well, it's done by thumb. Your thumb now, maybe next time it will be my thumb. I'm not up to that level for now, but I'm getting there. Praise the Lord! So don't overstretch yourself financially. Don't do it, especially in your homes and the other of your endeavors. Again, watch your associations and your friends. It's not everybody that is qualified to be your friend. Watch what they say. Watch what they believe on. There is some woman will tell you, I will deal with that man though. Okay, man, I'm gonna tell you. He can't mess with me. And this, he didn't buy the other one. Ah, no, I won't take it, you. He got for marriage. Evil communications corrupt good manner. Cut that woman off. Cut her off. Any woman, any lady that will make you to destabilize your home by her unworthy advice, counsel, cut her off. Greet her, but not taking her counsel. Amen. You watch, you see that our homes, most of our homes are struggling, they're in shambles. Most of the homes have been broken because of counsel from outside, ungodly counsel that you can't see anywhere in the Word of God. Where is it written that every Christmas you must buy things? Buy them. Buy this, buy this, buy this. Where is it in the Bible? What of if you buy it in March? Praise the Lord. Why must it be December? December, you see that a lot of people carry headache. They carry a lot of headache. And then, in psychology, we call it misplaced aggression. And somebody will come their way because of the load they are carrying. They are aggressive. They are carrying loads. They are carrying loads. The children, hey. My wife, hey. My husband, hey. My relations, they are carrying loads. Loads that even their parents could not carry, they want to carry. God will deliver us. We will walk as wise people in the name of Jesus. Again, for the married ones, not for the unmarried, don't refuse sex to your spouse except on the grounds of health or you want to engage in serious fasting and prayer. And then, there's an Igbo adage that says, "Na mwenye jurafo, adiapo ni ilo, ayon ni." A child that is well fed does not go outside to say, "Mommy, you need food. Mama, I am Maria. Maka, mommy, I need onye give me." If you know, you know. Get sex. Hallelujah. I move. Share your problems and worries with your wife, your husband. There are certain things that you are keeping for yourself. For how long? These are worries. These are problems in your home. These are the things you are going through in your place of work. And your boss wants to take sexual advantage of you. And you're hiding it from your husband. And you're hiding it from your wife. Don't you know that even if he says that, "Abakasiyon on your mom and your boy of fofo." Tell your wife, tell your husband, and you will agree in prayers. One day, somebody left Abuja and came down here for the sole purpose of trying to lure my husband into sin. But already, my husband discussed with me and we agreed in prayers. This is what you tell her. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't carry your burdens alone. Share. Share with your spouse. If you're having problems, share with your husband. If you have your revelations you don't understand, share with your wife. Perhaps she will give you the word of wisdom on what you will do. Don't carry your problems alone. Do we understand?
Yes, ma'am.
God bless you. For the youths, don't get into any blood covenant with any girl or boy. The person can tell you, if you love me, prove it. Let's enter into blood covenant. Lick my blood, lick your blood. It's something very serious, though. It's very, very serious. Don't agree with any boy. Youths, are you hearing me? Wave your hand and shout hallelujah. God bless you. Any blood covenant, We'll marry you in 10 years' time, in 5 years' time. So, let's take a blood covenant. Leak my blood. Don't agree. Don't ever agree. That is a demonic saying. It's not for you. Don't agree. Because the consequences are great. Hallelujah. Finally, get close to God. Don't leave God. Don't go back to the world. Paul says, for Demas has forsaken me, having loved this present world. Be wise. Get sense. Know that if you go with God, you will end with God. But if you don't go with God, you will end with Satan. Don't leave God for anything. The problems you see, they are for today. Tomorrow, you will not see them in Jesus' name. The hardship you see in your homes, in your families, in your academies today, they are not forever. God will deliver you and make a way for you in the name of Jesus. Another adigide. Tell your neighbor, another adigide. It's not forever. It's not forever. What you do not get today, the cars that are coming, the helicopters that are coming. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell what you need, level by level, stage by stage. Work as a wise person this week, this month, this year, and many, many years to come. May that grace be given unto you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lift your hand and say, my Father, help me to walk as a wise person in all my endeavors.